What is the science behind Wanda Maximoff's magic? In this video, I'm going to take a look at the possible science behind one of Wanda's spells from WandaVision, the Probability Hex. Hi, I'm Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist, and on this channel you'll find videos in relation to the science and engineering behind superheroes, superpowers, and other interesting topics. If you're new here, please be sure to subscribe and ring the bell for notifications on the latest videos. Let's get into the magic of Wanda Maximoff. The Disney Plus series WandaVision has been a revelation with many shocks and twists along the way. Notably, in the series, Wanda creates her own small world in Westview in New Jersey, and she even creates her own Vision and her own kids, Billy and Tommy. In episode 8, we see a series of traumatic events from Wanda Maximoff's past. One of those events is from Sokovia and is referenced in Avengers Age of Ultron. It's the scene where Wanda and Pietro find themselves trapped in their apartment after a missile lands in their apartment and doesn't explode. The missile, well, it's a Stark Industries missile. In the episode, though, it transpires that Wanda already had some magical abilities, and in fact, she was stopping the missile from exploding by casting a probability hex. So how would a probability hex work? Well, to get into the details of some of the science behind Wanda's magic, we need to think quantum. Yes, indeed, to explore the probability hex, we need to dive into the quantum world. But before we get into quantum things, let's first meet probability. Right, very quickly, probability. Here's a 2 euro coin. If I flip it, I've got two possibilities, heads or tails. They're both equally likely to happen, provided that it's a fair coin. That being the case, the probability of heads is a half and the probability of tails is a half. That's the probability of something happening. But what about the probability of something being located somewhere? Here's a house. It's quite a nice house. In the macro world or the big world, the probability of that house being located there, when you look at it, is an unusual statement to make. But in this case, the probability would be one. That's the probability of something happening, like a coin toss, or the probability of something being somewhere, like the location of the house. Speaking about the probability of something being located somewhere in the macro world or the big world in which we live sounds a little bit unusual. But in the small world, at the length scale of tiny particles such as electrons, the location of an electron or a similar tiny particle is not as clear cut. Here is an electron. An electron is negatively charged, and it's a fundamental particle or building block of all atoms. Indeed, you will find electrons in orbit around the nucleus of an atom. In the nucleus, you will find protons and neutrons, but in orbit around it, you'll find electrons. The interesting thing about electrons is that they can collide with each other in the very same way that two balls on a pool table might collide with each other. Electrons can also behave as waves. This might seem a little bit unusual. But particles, fundamental particles, can exhibit a behavior known as particle-wave duality. This means that they can behave as particles and they can behave as waves. Light acts as a wave when it travels through space or around us, but when it's measured, it behaves as a particle. That particle is called a photon. The same can be said for electrons. When electrons are moving through the air, they could be seen as waves. But when they're measured, you detect the particle, and the particle in this case is an electron. As I've mentioned, at these tiny scales, when you're talking about particles like electrons, you can never be sure where exactly you might find the electron. There is a probability of where the electron might exist. And that probability is associated with the type of wave that represents the electron. This wave is sometimes referred to as a wave function. And when you have one electron, you have one wave function. But when you have a bunch of electrons together, you have a single wave function to describe all of those electrons as one unit. This is quantum mechanics, and quantum mechanics is all about the behavior of the smallest of particles. And as I've mentioned, some of the things they do might seem a little bit weird. Right, that's probabilities, and that's a little bit on quantum mechanics. So how did Wanda use her magic to cast a spell called the Probability Hex and stop the bomb from detonating? Well, here's how I think she did it. First off, the missile was a Stark Industries missile made by Stark Industries, of course associated with Tony Stark. And from the 2008 film Iron Man, we know that some of the missiles developed by Stark Industries have a delayed detonation. This means that the bomb does not detonate upon impact and instead detonates a few seconds later. To control this delayed detonation of the missile must contain some sort of microchip or control chip that sends an electrical signal from the central computing unit of the missile to the part that actually instigates the detonation of the missile. And that's where Wanda's probability hex comes into play. In effect, she cast a spell that stops the electrical signal moving from the microchip to the element of the missile that will instigate or start the detonation. So how did she do it? Let's take a very simplified look at how this whole detonation process works in the missile. Here is a simplified version of the microchip in the missile. It is this chip that will send the electrical signal to the sparking component of the missile to lead to the detonation. That signal is made up of electrons, and the electrons will make their way towards the spark component. When they reach the sparking component, they will carry the instruction to spark, and that will lead to the detonation of the explosive element of the missile, and that's when the missile explodes. Let's zoom in on what's happening between the microchip and the sparking device of the missile. Well, we know that the microchip will send out a signal in the form of electrons. And let's imagine that it must travel between those two red bars, which indicate the start and end point from the microchip to the sparking device. Those electrons carry the signal that needs to be transmitted from the microchip to the sparking device. And in terms of a probability of where you might find the electrons between those two red lines, the probability will be one, that you will find them at some point between those two red lines. The key element of the probability hex is that it affects the probability of where you might find the electrons in the space between the microchip and the electric spark generator for the missile. And that's what she changed. And this is how she would have done it, I think anyway. Let's take a look once again at the arrangement of the microchip and the sparking device. We know that when the electrons leave the microchip, the probability of the electrons being found very close to the microchip will be equal to 1. And the idea here is with the hex spell, you want to prevent the electrons from reaching the sparking device. In other words, you want the probability of the electrons to be found close to the sparking device to be pretty much 0. And that's where the spell is cast. And a spell is cast and introduces a barrier. And this is a barrier that the electrons cannot move through or penetrate. And as a result, the probability of the electrons being found very close to the sparking device will effectively become 0. As a result, this stops the signal from getting from the microchip to the sparking device. Now, this barrier is really important because it prevents one other quantum effect called quantum tunneling. Yes, some particles, including electrons, have the ability to tunnel through barriers. It's like they can travel through walls to get from one point to another. But provided that that barrier that Wanda introduces with her probability hex is large enough and thick enough, then no electrons are going to make their way through. And as a result, the probability of electrons being close to the sparking device will be 0. And if that's the case, the missile is not detonating. That's my proposal for how the probability hex actually works and how it prevented the detonation of the missile. It's rough, I'll admit that, and does not take into account all quantum effects that might actually influence the whole process. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'll be very happy to hear what you think about the whole probability hex. Thanks for watching this video on Wanda's magic and the probability hex, and be sure to stay tuned for more videos in the future. I've been Dr. Barry Fitzgerald, the superhero scientist. And until I see you next time, always think super.